and welcome to another episode of Startup Hustle Middle East. We're very excited to be a media partner for STEP Conference this year and to meet really exciting entrepreneurs from the region. So today we're talking to Tarik, who is the CEO and founder of Localyser, which is an online reputation management tool.
Yep.
So Tarik, welcome on the show.
Thank you very much.
Can you give us the elevator pitch of Localyser?
Sure. So Localyser is a review management platform. We help retail, restaurants, hospitality, luxury brands manage all of the reviews across the web all from one place.
Okay.
So if you have multiple outlets or you have multiple brands and you really care about what people are saying about you at the location level, we aggregate all the reviews from Google, Facebook, TripAdvisor, Zomato, Talabat, and we bring it to you in one dashboard so you can monitor, respond, and analyze all from one place.
Okay, so I think it's interesting for the listeners because not only did I meet you here, I've actually had hands-on experience with the tool for one of our clients, which is an F&B client.
Correct.
And I was very surprised and delighted to hear that it's all been locally, it's a locally developed solution.
Right.
We've spoken to a lot of founders that rely on technology resources from outside the region. So I think that's quite interesting. But what has been some of the challenges that you faced while developing Localyser?
So the challenge is obviously, you know, we wanted to make sure that we are developing something that is tailored for the region, right? So obviously our tool has different systems. Applications for it. We know there are different platforms like that outside, but we worked with our first client that we signed 3 years ago, and we started getting feedback from them so we can optimize the platform.
Okay.
For example, one of the things that we did is, because we are in Dubai, we're multicultural, multinationals, we get reviews in many, many different languages.
Yeah.
English, Hindi, Arabic, Russian, Chinese.
Yeah.
So one of the features that we provide that nobody else does is we auto-translate all of that into English.
That's right? Amazing, yeah.
And we aggregate reviews from regional platforms that nobody has. I'm talking like multinational.
Like Talabat, basically.
Right, exactly.
Yeah.
Sometimes those platforms don't have the necessary APIs to connect with, so we have to find ways to collect, you know, partner with them and collect all the different reviews versus the Googles of the world where they're, you know, very advanced, very sophisticated. Yeah. That was one of the issues that we had.
Okay, great. So what are your plans for Localyser? How are you looking to scale and grow? Aside from the expected, yes, of course, you want to work with more clients, but what is your vision for Localyser?
So the vision is to become really the region's go-to place for as a review platform.
Okay.
So not only do we have our own web application interface for our own clients, but we launched our own white label solution. So, for example, agencies can now take this and offer it to their own clients.
Mm-hmm.
We're launching our own review API.
Okay.
So third-party developers can take reviews and enhance their own apps or applications like listings.
Okay.
We're building a response API management system.
Mm-hmm.
So, again, third-party developers can actually not worry about how do I integrate with the third with those review systems. So we want to become a platform so that not only our clients can use it, but our partners, channel partners,
agencies,
developers
yeah.
can also benefit from the technology that we've built.
Okay, great, awesome. And is this the first time that you're having a booth at STEP?
Yes, this is our first time. We've been coming here for quite some time.
As visitors,
but,
yeah.
you know, we felt like this is the right time for us to come in. We're part of in5. Our startup is at in5 Techs. So it was great to come in as part of the in5 startup team and have a stand here at STEP.
Okay. And how have you found the event? Have you made some interesting connections? Have you had some cool learnings from the event? How have you found the event so
far? So obviously STEP is probably one of the best networking events, especially if you're in a startup digital ecosystem. So obviously, we met so many different potential channel partners.
Okay,
that's really great. And that's what we expected. We didn't expect to meet direct clients, although we met a couple of you know, F&B clients. But
that's amazing.
And also it gives us exposure. It's kind of like our coming brand out party and that sort of thing. So it's been great so far.
Okay. And what advice would you give to startups considering the ecosystem in the region?
Right. So one of the first things when I started, somebody handed me a book, the Lean Startup book.
We've done an episode on the Lean Startup methodology.
And I use it as my Bible, to be honest.
Okay.
I love the fact how it's broken into, you know, first you have to validate the idea.
Yeah.
And then you build the MVP to come up, do the product market fit, and then you scale. And those two first, I think a lot of startups rush into it.
Yeah.
They take an idea outside and they just implement it. I think the idea validation and the MVP stage are really critical in this part of the world, because even if you you have to localize it, it's very different. It looks like it's the same as anywhere else in the world, but there's so many different mechanics and logistical issues
that come
with the region, and you have to go through it. So take your time to validate your idea, to achieve product market fit, and then go for money and scale and it will be much easier for you.
Okay, great, awesome. You should check out our episode on the Lean Startup methodology.
We've covered
that. Yeah.
Awesome.
Yeah, great. Thanks a lot for being on the
show.
Thank you. And good luck with Localyser.
Thank you so much.
I just had one question. What did you think of the in5 experience? Like, would you recommend it to other entrepreneurs?
Yeah, so when we looked at where we're going to set up our startup, we looked at so many different incubators, accelerators, business centers, what are we going to do? Mm-hmm. We chose in5 because they really take all the hassle of, you know, trade license, setting up your business, getting the visas, the location, the office.
Yeah.
All of that, which is new for...
A huge headache.
Is a huge headache, especially if you've never done it before. So that one was really great. The second thing is the space itself. It's really ideally located.
Which in5 are you in?
The in5 Tech in Knowledge Village.
In Knowledge Village.
Right. Okay. It's really well designed. We can invite clients to come in. Makes us look really good.
Yeah.
The events that they have. Also, the fellow entrepreneurs that are at in5, where they're kind of our support network.
Oh, nice.
You know, it's like, are you going through this? How did you do that?
So
it was really a good setup, a good place for us to be and not worry about any of the issues that other startups have to worry about.
Okay, very interesting. Cool. Great.
Highly recommend it.
Yeah.
All right, awesome. Thanks for being on the show.
Yeah.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Awesome. All the best.
Okay.
Today, we have with us Tania Farha, who is the co-founder of Weltou, which is a wellness initiative.
Absolutely.
Yes.
Yeah.
So can you tell us a little bit about Weltou?
Yeah. So Weltou.com is an online wellness consultation platform that helps users in the MENA region connect with verified global experts in real time.
Okay.
Yeah.
And why have you tied up with global experts rather than using local experts?
Well,
is there a gap?
Well, we have both, actually.
Okay.
But one of the problems we're trying to solve is allowing users to connect with experts that perhaps they don't have, but they can't find locally. So,
okay.
You know,
okay. Yeah. And how did you come up with the idea when you said it's going to launch on the 3rd of March?
Absolutely. We're in soft launch stage at the moment. So I am a nutrition coach by profession, and I did this for many, many years. And my co-founder as well is in that space. So we started to see patterns, you know, rising where a breach. So people sometimes cannot find the right experts that they need locally. Convenience. So, you know, people who are working find it very difficult to take the time to leave work to
go visit somebody.
Privacy. So again, in this part of the world, there's stigma with getting help sometimes, especially when we talk about mental health, therapy, and so on. People don't like to be seen in a therapist's office. Sometimes they don't even want to consult with somebody that's local. You know, they prefer to share with an expert that's overseas.
Okay, it's almost a little bit anonymous then.
Anonymous, right. And obviously budget as well. So there's, you know, you can find somebody within your budget wherever you are. Our experts price themselves. So we have experts, you know, that range from literally $40 up to $200 and something. So there's something for everyone. Yeah.
Okay. And can you expand a little bit on everything that the wellness area
what it means?
Includes?
Yeah. So initially we're focusing on four things, which are therapy, nutrition, health coaching, and life coaching.
Okay.
And obviously within each one there's a breakdown of, you know, different expertise and things like that. So we have therapists that focus on couples therapy, others that do family therapy, some on bereavement, and so on. So, you know, yeah, very different.
Okay. I know of someone that recently lost someone. And is going for grief counseling.
Yes.
So is that something that's
so that's what we call, well, we've named it bereavement counseling, but that's what it is. Absolutely.
Okay. But do you think that there is a requirement to do it in a support group kind of session, so with multiple people talking about their experiences? Is that something that you don't cover, or
at the moment we don't cover that?
It's
It is one-on-one. We have we're getting feedback already from experts about what they're looking for, and we have had experts asking for. So our sessions happen by video conferencing, and they're asking whether it can be many people video conferencing in at the same time, which would be, you know, could be applied in the case of a support group, or in the case of an expert wanting to provide a workshop, you know, or something like that. So I think this will definitely be phase B. Something we will look into for phase B,
Okay, great. And how did you, I mean, you said that you've been a nutrition consultant. Yeah. So when did you come up with the idea? How did you connect with your co-founder? Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Yeah, so the idea came around about a year and a half ago, 2 years ago. And really, it came from wanting to have a bigger impact regionally rather than just consulting one-on-one. So we wanted to create something that has a ripple effect, you know. So we love the concept of bringing wellness into people's homes, you know, and having a much bigger impact. So
and making it accessible, I guess.
Accessible, you know, it's almost like democratizing wellness in a way. So my partner was somebody I knew socially. We were both working in kind of the same field. And we started, you know, discussing it. And, you know, as anybody who has a startup will tell you, initially you're like, is it a viable concept? We don't know, whatever. Yeah. And we were both, you know, we just thought it's worth a shot. Obviously, it's a concept that exists already elsewhere in the world, primarily for medical. I think we're one of the early adopters of wellness via video conferencing. Okay. And it works really, really, really well for many reasons. I think everybody, as we said, has something they want to work on. And just, you know, making that easy, accessible to them is great. So we started about a year and a half ago.
Okay.
And it's been an extremely interesting journey. We've learned a lot. And it's very nice to see it.
A lot of our listeners are aspiring entrepreneurs. So what advice would you give someone who's looking to start a business?
In tech specifically.
In tech specifically, Or something from your experience that you've learned.
So I think, if you're going to start a concept in the region, localizing it is extremely important. So it's not just about, you know, because I think many entrepreneurs see concepts that exist abroad and they
want
to bring them here.
And
you really need to know the local market. Sometimes it functions very differently. So you have to have a very strong localization aspect to it. So, you know, for sure, bilingual platform, I mean, that's a minimum.
Yours bilingual?
Yes, it is.
Okay.
And really making the, you know, MENA users your primary focus. Also within the MENA region, users differ, you know, so Saudi is quite different to Lebanon. So you have, you know, when you're doing your marketing, you have to really learn who are we speaking to in these individual markets. And for us also, one of our main things, obviously, when you go in tech is having really strong tech developers and a team you can work with. A lot of startups can't afford to hire their own. So we did not hire our own to start with, and we had to outsource and really do your homework and take your time, because this is the most important part of it. You know, you need somebody who can help you with the user journey, who are problem solvers, who
provide a seamless user experience.
And who are preferably bilingual, because if you use developers who do not speak Arabic and you're catering to the Arabic region, believe me, you're gonna
going
have
to
have issues.
Be a problem. Yeah. Yeah. So you're speaking from experience.
Yes.
Okay, great.
Yeah.
And this is the first time that you're at STEP and showcasing.
Yes, absolutely.
Considering
that
you're a new startup. So what do you think of the event so far?
It's been amazing for us. You know, we weren't quite sure initially what to expect and what to get out of it. But we've made a lot of connections. And we've met other entrepreneurs who have some businesses that can complement ours. So
it's
about cross-marketing or how can we potentially work together and things like that. So it's been really, really interesting. Yeah.
Okay, great. Awesome. And you are part of the in5 community,
I
would say.
Yeah.
And how has that been? What value have they added? If they've added
value. It's been great. Yeah, you know, again, as a startup, you need all the support you can get. So for me and my partner, we've both been entrepreneurs before, but in brick and mortar businesses, we've never been in tech. So, you know, it's quite a daunting thing moving into that space. And, you know, being part of an accelerator that supports you from the outset, I mean, A, financially, because they help subsidize our, you know, they subsidize your licenses and they give you a great co-working space where you can bounce ideas off other entrepreneurs.
Founders, yeah.
But also, you know, the mentoring that you get, this opportunity of being at STEP, and they kind of guide you, you know, until you're ready to go out into the real world. Yeah, it's been really great. I can't imagine having done it any other way, to be honest.
Okay, amazing.
Yeah.
Well, we'll keep our eyes open for
Weltou's so
launch on the 3rd of March.
3rd of March, absolutely.
Awesome, and wish you all
Thank
the best.
Thank you so
Thank
much.
You. Okay, we have one more question from Sid.
Yeah.
Okay, so what is the monetization strategy and how much would it cost customers?
So the experts price themselves.
Okay.
We don't get involved in their pricing and we operate on a revenue share.
With the experts.
With the experts, exactly.
Okay. So you want to make it as, you mentioned you want to make it as easy as possible for customers to choose from a $40
they do.
An hour.
Absolutely.
To
and, you know, initially we were thinking of making it all one price. It's impossible because you've got experts who have written books and written PhDs, and you have 25 years experience, and then you have you know people who just graduated. So, it just works much better that way.
And is it an app-based platform?
At the moment, well, for MVP, we decided to go with a platform just simply because
with a web platform,
okay. Because the you know we imagine the experts might be in an office and they have a laptop, and it's just easier.
Okay.
Phase two will definitely see an app.
Okay, great, awesome. Today, we're at STEP Conference, which is amazing because we got to meet some really interesting founders. So one of them is Gurpreet, he is the founder of the startup called Illuminate, which is part of the in5 family. So can you give us your elevator pitch? What does Illuminate do?
I think I need a few extra floors in the elevator.
Okay, take your time then.
Basically provide business software in a very quick way to describe it, but is a business platform, and on this platform we've built a number of applications.
Okay.
The easiest way to contrast it to our competitors. So in the market you see the big guys, which are the SAP, the Oracles, the Microsofts, the Salesforce, and these big platforms, while great in themselves, they're very costly.
Yeah.
Very hard to implement for organizations. It takes really a special set of skills to do this right, and takes a lot of effort. And in fact, there's a bit of rigidity there, in the sense that you'd have to make customizations to get all the features that you need in the application. So
do they integrate well with other products?
Yes, they do integrate, but it ends up being very costly for businesses.
Okay.
And then on the other side, our target market, which is small, medium businesses and enterprises as well, small enterprises, they're basically forced to look at apps.
Okay.
And apps that, you know, you go onto the app store, they'll get this for their HR, they'll get another app for their ordering, they'll get another app for invoicing.
So it's a complicated tech stack.
Yeah. So then you end up with, from our research shows, about 10 to 15 different apps to run a business. And now you have a different problem. One is, the apps, you take them as is and you use them. There's no flexibility to customize. The second thing is integration.
Yeah.
These apps are not integrated and they don't talk to each other. So what we've done is we've taken the best of sort of both worlds. We've taken that platform concept, built our own platforms from scratch, our own technology, mobile-enabled cloud technology from the ground up, team of engineers put that together, And then from the other side, we took the app concept and we built apps on our platform.
Okay. So is Illuminate the business or the technology solution brand?
So name? Illuminate is the name of the business.
Name of the business.
And our apps, all our apps have different names. For example, our logistics app, which is called Cargo. It helps drivers navigate to get their deliveries on time. We have a CRM solution called Rise. Rise CRM. We have a field execution tool if you have merchandisers going out in the field, mystery shopping, all those field execution tools, activities. You can use our Journey app. So businesses can pick and choose the apps they need, and best yet, if they have another app or an existing solution, they can just plug it into our platform.
Okay, and how long have you been operational? And did you start with such a wide set of apps?
No, I mean, in 2016, we started to build out the apps. Myself, I'm one of the co-founders. The other co-founder is Amr, who's also my wife, and partner in crime here. She heads up the sales and marketing. I head up the dev and operations. In the last 15 years, been in IT consulting, working with companies like Logitech, Microsoft, Unilever, Jamera, and delivering solutions. And it was this learned experience that drove us to looking at this platform concept that we made.
Okay. And when you started in 2016, you said, did you start as part of in5 or did you join them much later?
No, we were actually doing a consulting assignment out here in Dubai. We had gone back to actually Canada and started working on the platform. We actually came out here to close up our shop and our belongings and launch our product back into Canada, which we had already started doing.
Okay.
And then we got the opportunity to be part of in5.
Okay.
We went through the process. It was an amazing process, and we got accepted. And then we thought, this is an amazing platform. Number one, in5 offers us a great facility. Not just one facility, but three different facilities to work out of.
That's correct, yeah.
Which one
are you in?
We're in in5 Tech.
Tech, okay.
And at the same time, we got the whole licensing, business registration, all that overheads. It's a real, sometimes it can be really challenging in Dubai, but, you know, they were there to, you know, walk us through it and help us. And, of course, provide us the support as a startup to even subsidize that. To give us the financial ability to go forward and really launch into this region, which is actually a great region for us to actually launch into.
Okay, amazing. So is Canada not in the plan right now, or
not right now? I mean, it will be. I mean, we haven't stopped selling in Canada, but we're here in the GCC now. We're a part of in5. Our strongest growth is right here in the Middle East. So we see our growth market to be here. I mean, we want to be in our backyard before we go to the neighbors.
Okay. I think also considering that maybe the UAE is not as technologically advanced as Canada, maybe it's more low-hanging fruit here?
Exactly. I mean, when I mentioned the big guys, they are here and they are working with a lot of, you know, different organizations. But in the SMB space, time and time again, both Amr and I, when we go to businesses, we talk to them. Our real competitors is Excel. You know, people are working in Excel.
Yeah.
You know, poor souls.
So not the people that are using SAP.
Yeah, they're gluing together things in Excel, doing data transformation. They're spending their days and nights making graphs and charts and trying to make sense of the data. And you know what? This is a perfect opportunity for us. And this is why we're here.
To sell them the convenience of it all.
Exactly.
Yeah.
You know, start with
automation,
one app.
Yeah.
And the thing is that it's our platform makes it really low risk for business because they're not buying into a massive platform requiring a sizable investment. You can get started literally today, take one of our apps, let's say the logistics apps, get your drivers set and going. And if you like it, I'm more than sure you will. You'll come back and start looking at our other product portfolio as well.
And how do you monetize right now? Is it subscription-based app service?
It's a subscription-based app service, yes. And it's super affordable compared to our competitors. You know, where our competitors are charging $100+ USD for what
one
we're selling for one user,
yeah.
We're charging less than 30.
Okay,
you know, so
great.
It's really affordable. And then in addition to that, we try to really understand the SMBs and SMEs. So we do offer consulting, which comes from our previous experience.
Which you charge for?
Which initially we do give it as part of our package, but if they need some additional consulting, we do charge for it.
Okay.
And as well as customization, part of our package is that, hey, listen, you get these apps, but we're not expecting you to use them as it is. Tell us what you need, and we'll help customize them for you. And there could be a serviceable charge for it.
Okay, amazing. So a lot of our listeners are entrepreneurs or thinking about entrepreneurship. And entrepreneurship has almost become a little bit sexy now, right? Like, it's cool to be an entrepreneur. I work out of my jeans and, you know, out of the beach and things. So I think a question that we always ask entrepreneurs that we feature is, what advice would you give entrepreneurs or people that are thinking of starting a business?
I would say, number one, hustle.
Mm-hmm.
We
call it Startup Hustle Middle East, so there you go.
There you go. But then when you're leaving a corporate environment, you're working 9 to 5 and you're getting a regular paycheck, it's very comfortable.
Yeah.
Coming to a startup, everything is in dog years, as we say in Illuminate. One day translates into, you know, a week. A week translates to a month.
Because of the amount of experiences you're collecting?
Oh, no, because of you don't have the time scale as a big corporation. Yeah. You know, if you start an employee today, you can't wait for that employee to ramp up in 3 months.
Yeah, yeah.
Right? We really need to get that person, he or she, going in about, you know, a few days.
Yeah.
So we have dog ears in terms of time space. And the other thing is, use the facilities around you. Like today at and the day before, just here at Startup, there's a lot of great programs, government initiatives. For example, look at in5. In5, as a startup, they don't take equity into your business. They really give you a platform to launch your business. There's a level of mentorship and guidance that is available there. And not to say that they interfere in your business at all, but they are really there to support you with any things that you need. So why not use them?
Yeah,
you know,
that's amazing.
You know, these things are available to you. So, you know, make the most of them.
Yeah, the ecosystem is really growing. So we started this podcast because we listen to a lot of startup-based podcasts. But also, my husband has a startup. It's called HR Car. And we felt that we learned so much in the journey, and it started 2 years ago, and already we can see that the ecosystem is quite evolved now.
Yeah.
So I've been attending STEP probably from the get-go, and already the kind of founders that you're getting, the kind of startups that are being launched, the kind of support there is from people to offer mentorship, it's growing.
It's growing.
It's still a long way to go, but it's growing, which is great. And I just want to put out a disclaimer that we are not sponsored by in5. We've happened to interview 3 founders that are part of the in5 community, all of whom have had a really good experience with them, but not sponsored by in5.
Well, look at this conference. I'm here today because of in5.
Okay.
So if you look at why I'm, I didn't have to pay a penny out of my own back pocket to be here. There's a facility of in5 that's made this possible for me, and I met great companies, great partners, and other even VC firms here.
Okay.
We already seed funded as well, but looking forward, I mean,
you've made some connections.
Exactly.
Yeah,
and
because
so
of them.
We've already started looking at our future planning and the next few years. So this event is facilitating that process of planning.
Yeah, great. Awesome. Well, thanks a lot for being on the show, Gurpreet.
Thank you for having me.
And wish you all the best with Illuminate.
Cheers.
All right.
Bye-bye.